welcome back. It's Storybook Land Theatre week 2 in our 32nd season. I know we're not in the castle and you're watching us at home, and boy, are we grateful for that. So thanks for tuning in. Let me introduce all my friends to you real quick. My name is Brian, still.
Hi, Brian.
I'm still Brian, always have been Brian, always will be Brian. Next to me is my best friend and your best friend. It's Kara.
Hi, Kara.
And then next to her wearing purple is my best friend and your best friend, Haven.
Hi, Haven.
And then next to her wearing yellow, it's your best friend and my best friend. It's Kane.
Hi, Kane.
And then down there wearing red, your best friend and my best friend, Anne Marie.
Hi, Anne Marie.
Next to her wearing purple is your best friend and my best friend, Emily.
Hi, Emily.
And then swinging around this way wearing green is your best friend and my best friend, Austin.
Hi, Austin.
And then next to him wearing red is your best friend and my best friend, it's Claire.
Hi, Claire.
We are so thrilled that you're here joining us. I'm so excited for today's show, aren't you? What are we doing today?
We're doing The Boy Who Cried B.
I like this one a lot.
Perfectly timed for the 4th of July happening tomorrow.
Oh yeah, oh yeah.
And happy 4th of July to everybody out there.
Yes, I hope you're planning on blowing stuff up in the name of America. I say that every year and it never gets old. Well, we know that normally when you come to our shows in the castle, we like to warm up and play some games and stuff together to kind of get, you know, excited to see a show and, you know, shake all the wiggles out and that kind of thing. So this is something that you can do at home, and we want you to send us pictures or videos of you and your whole family doing these games at home. Because why?
Because we have a special opportunity. If you are, you can send us a picture or video and your family playing along with doing our warm-ups, you have a chance to win a fun prize from this week's sponsor,
which is
Diamond Dry Cleaners.
Diamond awesome. Dry Cleaners?
Wow. I love dry cleaning.
I love diamonds.
Also, just yes. Because it's fun to do.
Yes. Okay. So send us pictures or videos of you playing along, and you'll get a chance to win some kind of prize.
That's you and your family, so everyone has to play to be eligible.
That means you, Dad.
That's right. No, just sitting in the armchair smiling. Oh, yeah. Look at the cute kids. All right, so let's get things started. What's our first warm-up today?
Flea Fly Mosquito.
Awesome, Flea Fly Mosquito. All right, this one's very easy if you've never played it before. All you have to do is hit your lap and then clap, okay? Well, let's start that and see if we can stay together. Here we go. See, just nice and chill. Don't slap the lap too hard because this is a long song, okay? The first movement alone is about 45 minutes. I'm just kidding. Repeat after me. Here we go. Flea.
Flea.
Flea fly.
Flea fly.
Flea fly mosquito.
Flea fly mosquito.
Itchy, itchy, scratchy, scratchy. Ooh, I got one down my backy.
Itchy, itchy, scratchy, scratchy. Ooh, I got one down my backy.
Get that big bad bug with the bug spray.
Get that big bad bug with the bug spray.
Excellent. Now, we're going to speed it up a little bit. Yeah, just a little bit. That means you. Slow it down. Okay? No need to get all excited just yet. There's plenty of time. Flea.
Flea.
Flea fly.
Flea fly.
Flea fly mosquito.
Flea fly mosquito.
Itchy, itchy, scratchy, scratchy. Ooh, I got one down my backy.
Itchy, itchy, scratchy, scratchy. Ooh, I got one down my backy.
Get that big bad bug with the bug spray.
Get that big bad bug with the bug spray.
Now a little faster. There we go. Flea.
Flea.
Flea fly.
Flea fly.
Flea fly mosquito.
Flea fly mosquito.
Itchy, itchy, scratchy, scratchy. Ooh, I got one down my backy.
Itchy, itchy, scratchy, scratchy. Ooh, I got one down my backy.
Get that big bad bug with the bug spray.
Get that big bad bug with the bug spray.
Now faster. Flea.
Flea.
Flea fly.
Flea fly.
Flea fly mosquito.
Flea fly mosquito.
Itchy, itchy, scratchy, scratchy. Ooh, I got one down my backy.
Itchy, itchy, scratchy, scratchy. Ooh, I got one down my backy.
Get that big bad bug with the bug spray.
Get that big bad bug with the bug spray.
Now the fastest ever. Flea.
Flea.
Flea fly.
These are fun.
Yeah.
Mosquitoes.
Oh, did we take out the bees too?
Yeah.
Aww. Well,
bees always come back.
Dun, dun,
dun!
Oh my goodness, that's so, that makes you so nervous.
So what's happening next week?
So next week you can all come back because we are going to have another live show on Thursday, and this one is called It's a Plane, It's a Train, It's a Box? So we'll be having a performance on Thursday, July 9th at 7 o'clock out in the Wiley Park Zoo parking lot right across from Thunder Road in the northeast corner of Wiley Park.
Mm-hmm. Hope to see you all there.
Or you can find us online. You can find us on our Facebook page at SBL Theater, on our Instagram page at SBL Theater, or on our YouTube page at Storybook Land Theater.
Wow, I hope all these graphics line up with where we're pointing.
Yeah, me too.
We barely squeaked by last week. I have high hopes this week, making it 2 for 2.
You want to know what one of my favorite 4th of July things to do is?
What's
please
that?
Tell me.
Is before the fireworks, I like going out on the lake and swimming.
Ooh. Oh, yeah. And it's been plenty toasty. At least I hope it's been plenty toasty where we feel like we need to be swimming. So let's do a swimming song with us. So get your arms ready, okay? This is another very easy song, and it's got some fun actions and stuff, so we want to see you dancing along at home. And it goes like this.
Swimming, swimming in my swimming pool. When days are hot, when days are cold in my swimming pool. Side stroke, back stroke, fancy diving too. Don't you wish you never had anything else to do but...
Let's do that one more time, okay, in case you're learning it for the first time. Here we go.
Swimming, swimming in my swimming pool. When days are hot, when days are cold in my swimming pool. Side stroke, back stroke, fancy diving too. Don't you wish you never had anything else to do but... When days are hot, when days are cold in my swimming pool. Side stroke, back stroke, fancy diving too. Don't you wish you never had anything else to do but... Side stroke, back stroke, fancy diving too. Don't you wish you never had anything else to do but... Don't you wish you never had anything else to do but... But...
Anytime we get to end the song with the word but is a good day.
I agree.
Doesn't matter how old you are, it never gets old.
Now, before we get started with the episode, one more thing we have to do is thank our sponsors.
Oh, yes.
So we'd like to thank Aberdeen Parks, Recreation, and Forestry, Aberdeen Community Theaters, Young People's Theater, South Dakota Area Arts Council, Aberdeen Area Arts Council, and this week's sponsors, Diamond Dry Cleaning.
Remember, send us photos or videos of you playing along with the warm-ups, playing along with us. Everybody's got to play, and you'll have a chance to win some great prizes that we'll give away some way, somehow, so stay tuned for that. Let's see, anything else? Did we get everything?
I think so.
Are we just that good?
I think so.
That's amazing. All right, so let's get the show rolling. Thank you all so much for tuning in, and enjoy The Boy Who Cried Beep. Woo!
Last week on Storybook Land Theatre Primetime.
He crossed the line! I said, get out of here!
Well, you're gonna have to catch me first!
Look what you did!
Why is there a hole in the wall?
It was me, Mom. I came into the party and I was bothering them, and I was horsing around and I kicked a hole in the wall.
Austin, you're coming with me.
Happy birthday, Claire.
Yeah. Here's the story of some amigos who wanted to go play out in the sun. All of them have bowling shirts in different colors, looking to have some fun. It's the story of two great parents who were busy with two kids not fully grown. And their aunt from way up north, she sure is wacky, and she just won't go home. Till the one day some good friends and a family set off on some adventures that they seek. A brand new story that we know you will remember, premiering online and in person every week. We're Primetime now, we're Primetime now. Come and join us because we are Primetime now.
Are just about ready. What time do you say your folks will be here?
They said they'd be here around 5.
Great. That'll give Austin just enough time to mow this lawn. Where is that scamp?
Oh, last time I saw him, he was in the front yard painting like he's Picasso.
It's Picasso, dear.
Oh, yeah, that guy.
All right, Claire, go to the front and get your brother.
What's the magic word?
I'm your father. The magic word is me telling you to do it.
Okay.
Please go to the front and get him.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Austin!
Oh, Austin. I am glad he's finally found a hobby.
Yeah, I wish he were old enough to help me in the shop, but he can't run a saw if he can't have a lawn mowing, right?
Oh, shush.
Ooh, is that my broom?
Yes.
Ooh.
What's up? I was painting the neighbor's car.
What?
What?
A picture of the neighbor's car.
Oh. Well, great. The family's coming over. We need you to mow this whole lawn.
But, Dad...
No buts. We've been inside doing food all day. It's your turn to mow the lawn. Now, Claire, you wait out here. Austin will keep an eye on you. All right, here we go. Thank you, guys.
Surprise! Mom, Dad, you're here early.
So early.
There was surprisingly no traffic, and you know how your father gets 80 all the way.
Hey, great time.
Good to see you, Franny! Yay! And, Dad?
Yeah, I told you, don't ever call me that.
Say, Kane, your lawn's looking kind of shaggy.
Well, Frank, Austin was just about to mow, but you got here so early.
Well, that's no excuse. You know, my brothers and me used to be up at 4 a.m. to work the fields. 4 a.m.! And we were thankful. Unlike you, we knew how to have a good time and to work hard.
Oh, how are my sweet grandkids? Come give me some hugs.
Oh, you're squeezing me too tight. Well, since we're here, is there anything we can help with?
No,
you don't have to.
Oh, I insist. Come on, let's get out of this hot sun.
Well, before we do that, let's see if Granddad has a gift for the wonderful children.
Frank, you didn't have to give the kids anything.
Oh, they're my grandkids. I can give them gifts if I want to. Now, Claire, Austin, hold out your hands. Close your eyes. No peeking.
Okay.
Can't stand for no peeking. All right, now you can open them.
A coin? A whole coin.
That's right, it's a dollar coin, dagnabbit.
A dollar?
A dollar.
Thanks, Grandpa.
Ah, you're welcome.
Austin, what do you say?
It's just a dollar.
Just a dollar. Well, do you know how old I was before I got my first dollar? And I was thankful. I gave half of it to my family and half of it to the church. The other half went right in the bank. Now, if I were you, son, I'd take that quarter, take that dollar, take it straight to the bank, and just let it sit there. In a few years, you'll have doubled your money. Then how much will you have?
$2.
$2! Can you believe it?
All right, everybody. Hey, let's go inside. Come on, Dad.
I told you, don't call me that.
I told
Austin,
you.
Austin, you be careful. And watch your sister.
All right, Mom. Claire, don't get in my way or I'm going to run you over with a lawnmower.
Fine, as long as you don't get in my way as I plan my 4th of July spectacular-thon for the family. A 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10
need your help.
With what?
Well, I have to get back to my painting, and you know I hate mowing the lawn, so do you think you can take over doing it for me?
I don't know how to use the lawnmower. Besides, why would I help you? What's in it for me?
You can have the dollar that Grandpa gave me.
No, that's for your future. I know. You can help me with my spectacular-thon.
What?
You can assist me with the magic portion. Lay down.
Okay.
You ready?
No, this is ridiculous. Plus, you owe me for taking the blame for the hole in the wall. I lost my paints for a week.
That's in the past. Now, you're my assistant or no deal.
Fine.
Ugh. I hope you're ready to be sawed in half.
What?
Now, how do I use this thing?
Alright, well, first take it back to where we're going to start. So back here. So, I'll start it. All you have to do is press down on this bar and walk in a straight line. Got it?
Got it.
All right, ready? If you need me, I'll be over there!
Right now. What were you thinking? Your sister could have been seriously hurt.
I don't know. I guess I wasn't thinking.
No, you weren't. I can't believe this. I don't think you should come to us with the fireworks tonight. You should stay home with Pebbles.
Well, that's not fair. Why can't Pebbles go see the fireworks?
He's a turtle, son. They have sensitive ears.
Oh.
Now, you're going to get back to mowing. Come on, Frank. Let's go back inside and help the ladies.
You know, back in my day, my brothers and me made our own fireworks. We used to shoot Roman candles across the street to the neighbors.
Yeah. If Aunt Haven shows up, just send her inside.
All right, Dad.
Shoot him at the neighbors.
This is so unfair. I hate having to mow the lawn. I get all sweaty, itchy. Well, I guess I'll start so that I can go see the fireworks and be inspired for my best painting yet.
Well, what seems to be the problem here, gang?
Austin got a stain on his new church pants.
And it's a awards night banquet at your lodge tonight.
No worries, Camp. Why, just this morning, I spilled Red Rooster cold brew all over my good trousers. Well, I know just what to do. To Diamond Dry Cleaners. This is the answer to all our dry cleaning needs.
They do dry cleaning, shirt laundry, clean household items, make alterations, and you can even get help with leather.
I hope they can help with our trousers. But Dad, where are your pants?
Well, here they are now, fresh and clean.
Visit Diamond Dry Cleaners today at 1108 6th Avenue Southeast here in Aberdeen.
262-0132. Ah! Oh, Unhaven.
Hey there, bud. Dad making you mow the lawn?
Yeah, I have to finish or else I don't get to go see the fireworks tonight.
Oh, tough break, kid. You know, Dad always used to make me mow the lawn. Franny always got out of doing the hard job.
I know, it's so unfair. Claire never has to do anything.
I remember this one time, right before I went to college, I was mowing the lawn and it went right over to a nest of bees.
Never in my life have I seen so many angry bees. I got stung something awful. I had to wear sweaters in the middle of August just to hide all those stings.
Well, that sounds terrible.
Oh, it was. Mm-hmm.
Say, did you ever have to mow the lawn again after that happened?
Oh, no siree. My parents never made me do it ever again.
Interesting. Well, if you're looking for the rest of the family, they're inside. I better get working on the mowing.
Okay. Peace and love, little dove.
Bees.
I don't have my glasses.
Frank, stop! Oh, it's me.
Where are the bees, Austin? Are you okay?
Yeah. I'm okay. I think they're gone.
Oh, okay. Well, as long as you're all right, you get back to mowing. It's almost time for dinner. We'll be inside. You holler if you have any more bee problems.
What is wrong with you? Stop it!
Oh, I'm sorry all those bees stung you. You know, sometimes Mother Nature just comes after the wrong people. I remember this one time I was being chased by this little surly little squirrel.
Hey, and you Aunt Haven, I've never even been stung by a bee before. What does it feel like?
Have you been fermenting your kombucha on a hot stove and touched the pot?
No, Aunt Haven, I can't say that I have.
Okay. Have you been burning your incense and got one of those sticks lodged up your nose?
No.
Okay. Have you spilled a flaming hot pot of fondue on your Birkenstocks?
No, Aunt Haven, I haven't.
Well, it feels like that. Like all of that. And you get those little red marks on your skin from where you got stung.
That sounds awful.
Oh, it is. Now, before I go back inside, I just want to say thank you for painting the sunflowers on Uncle Edgar's and my VW bus. Totally radical.
Oh, it was no problem. I had a good time doing it.
Groovy. Now you get your mowing done.
Man, I wish I could just paint and not have to worry about mowing the lawn. Paint! Paint, of course, paint! I'm just gonna paint red dots on my arms so that it looks like I got stung by the bees. Why didn't I think about this earlier? All right. Little dot there, and one over here. Ooh, those look very painful. All right, now let's go to the other arm. All right. Oh, that's okay. Dot there, big dot there. Perfect.
We'd have to put a penny right on the sting.
Dad, stop that!
Well, it's true.
Is that a penny?
Ooh, that looks like it hurts.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, smelly.
It might sting a little.
No, oh Mom, that's okay. I think I got it from here.
The stings are vanishing. No, Aunt Haven, they aren't vanishing. They're washing off. It's paint.
Paint? Austin, you think this is funny? It's not okay to joke about these sort of things. We were scared to death. You know, I don't think you should go to the fireworks tonight.
Oh, no, Dad, please. Just let me go to the fireworks. I'll finish mowing the lawn. No more funny business, I promise. Cross my heart and hope to die.
Well, okay, but this is your last chance, okay? You need to finish the mowing. We were gonna go inside and get the rest of the food ready. We'll set the table, do our picture, and then it's time for dinner, huh?
Okay.
Okay, get to work. Hey, can you believe that kid?
What do you want?
Austin, I cannot let a liar, pants on fire be in my spectaculathon. Pebbles will be taking your place.
Best I better get finished. I finished, and I still get to go see the fireworks. What? Hey, get out of that, that's mine. Hey, go away. Leave me alone, bee. Buzz out of here. Darn bee trying to steal my drink. Hey, get out of here. Go away. Stupid bees. Where were you when I needed you? Bees are gone.
Alright, everybody. It's time for the family
show. Come on. Hey, Austin. How's it going? Good job, buddy. Oh, what happened to you?
My bees.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah. I bet it's just pain again, you liar.
Ow, you ignoramus. That hurt. Mom.
How was I supposed to know? He was a liar, pants on fire before.
Now, Claire, you shouldn't have hit your brother. But she is right, Austin. If you tell too many lies, people will start to not trust you.
You're right, Mom. I'm sorry, everybody. I didn't mean to scare you. I just wanted to paint.
Well, that's okay, Austin. I only told you my bee story to help cheer you up.
Oh, so that was you that told the bee story, you dirty hippie?
Be nice to my sister, Frank.
Sorry.
Oh, that's all right. But let's just get this picture taken so we can eat.
That is a great idea, David. All right, everybody, get clumps in. We're counting down 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4,
ow.
2, everyone say bees.
Bees!
Bees!
Oh! Oh.
Next week on Storybook Land Theatre Primetime.
Afternoon.
I've never seen a box this big before.
I know. We could use it to make a house. We could use it to hold the toads that we find in the grass. And we could, what do you guys think we can do?
We can use it as a shovel to dig to China.
Yeah.
Let's play a game.
Well, what game should we play?
Well, the possibilities are endless. Let's dip it over and see.
It's a plane. It's a train. It's a box.